Hello friend, this is Praveen Pawar. In this video, we are going to discuss the question paper of UGC NET July 2018. This is paper 2 of Electronic Science. In this video, we will see the questions from 81 to 100. For rest of the questions, for previous questions, please find the playlist available on my YouTube channel Praveen 254AA. So here we will start. There is a direction for questions 81 to 95. There will be assertion and reason. If assertion and reason both are true and reason is the correct explanation of assertion, we'll choose option 1. If both assertion and reason are true but reason is not the correct explanation of A, so we'll choose option 2. In case assertion is true but reason is false, we'll choose option 3. And if assertion is false but reason is true, we'll choose option 4. So here we'll start. Question number 81. Assertion is given in 8086 microprocessor ALE. This address latch enable is provided by the processor to latch the address into the 8282-8283 address latch. From its name and its function address latch enable, it is clear that it is used to latch the address. So this is correct statement. Whenever the processor sends a valid address on the multiplexed AD0 to AD15 lines, that is a 16-bit address line, it also makes the ALE high. ALE high enable at the first machine cycle. So this is also correct statement. This statement gives the explanation for this assertion. So both assertion is not true and reason gives the correct explanation of assertion. We will choose option 1. Now question number 82. In C, bit fields cannot be used in a union. So this is correct statement. If one element of union is initialized, then it also initializes other elements of the union. So this is also correct. But this reason is not the explanation of assertion. So we'll choose option 2 here. Now question number 83. Encapsulation is implemented by a class in C++. So this is a correct statement. Private, public and protected access specifiers are used. This is also correct. And because of this, the encapsulation will be implemented by a class in C++. This is the correct explanation of assertion. So here we will choose option 1. Now question number 84. The magnitude flux per unit length through a loop of a small length is called the magnetic flux density. So there is a error in the assertion. Here I will show you. The magnetic flux density is defined as the force acting per unit current per unit length on a wire placed at right angles to the magnetic field. This is the correct definition of magnetic flux density. So here assertion will say wrong. The direction of magnetic flux density is taken as the normal to the plane of the loop when oriented to enclose maximum flux. Here from the right angles to the magnetic field, it is clear that it should be normal to the plane of the loop. So this is correct. Here assertion is false and reason is true, so we will choose option 4. One more thing, the magnetic flux density is measured in webers per square meter, which is equivalent to Tesla. This is the unit of magnetic flux density. Now question number 85. For transmission lines having their length equal to odd multiples of lambda by 4, the following expressions are given. Sin beta l is equal to plus minus 1 and cos beta l is equal to 0. For odd multiples of lambda by 4, this is the correct statement. Under the above conditions, that is for odd multiples of quarter wavelengths, the input impedance becomes equal to z is equal to z naught cos h alpha l upon sin h alpha l. This is also correct statement and the explanation of the assertion. So here we will choose option 1. Question number 86. The Z parameters are open circuit parameters. This is the correct statement. In previous questions we have seen the Z parameters may be measured at one terminal while the other terminal is open. This is also correct. And because of this, it's called the open circuit parameters. So here we will choose option 1. Now question number 87. All the mesh currents are necessarily the loop currents, but all the loop currents may not be the mesh current. Here I will show you the difference between mesh current and loop current. Mesh is any closed path in a given circuit that does not have any element or branch inside it, while loop is also a closed path, but inside the closed path there may be one or more than one branches or elements. There is a basic difference between mesh and loop. So here may not be the mesh current. This is the correct statement. The mesh current is the current which flows only around the perimeter of a mesh. This is also a correct statement. So it, because of this, it distinguishes with the loop current. So here this is the correct explanation of assertion. We will choose option 1. Here is question number 88. Assertion is given. Vestigial sideband VSB gives rise to frequencies very close to the carrier frequency. So here I will show you the VSB modulation. Here you can see that there is a rise to frequency very close to the carrier frequency. So here this statement is correct. It is not possible to go to extreme and suppress one complete sideband by physically realizable filters. As we know that the sharp cut at the cutoff frequency in practical filters is not possible. There is a curve. So it is written that it's not possible to do extreme and suppress one complete sideband by physically realizable filter. This is also correct statement. So here reason and assertion both are true, and is it the explanation of assertion? So we will choose option 1. Now question number 89. Lesser number of bits per code are required due to less number of quantization levels in DPCM. DPCM is differential pulse code modulation or delta modulation. In this case, the difference between two successive samples is quantized, which do not differ much in amplitude. So here reason is correct and assertion is also correct, and due to this required less number of quantization levels in DPCM. So we'll choose option 1 here. Here I will show you a note that since successive samples do not differ very much, we send the differences between previous and present sample. So this reason is correct. It requires fewer bits than in PCM. Now question number 90. The hexadecimal numbers are first converted into binary numbers and operations are performed using binary representation of hexadecimal numbers using rules of binary numbers. This is correct statement. The information can be handled in hexadecimal form in digital circuits, but it is easier to enter information using binary numbers. So this statement is wrong, because we know that 4 bits in binary number, like 1001, represent, this is in binary, will represent a single digit like 9 in hexadecimal. So entering hexadecimal is easier than binary. So this statement is wrong. But in digital circuits, the information handled in binary. So you can say reason is wrong, but assertion is true. So we'll choose option 3. Now next question we have. Emitter coupled logic ECL is the fastest of all logic families and used in applications where very high speed is essential. Here again I will show you a table which we have used in question number 75. So here we will see that ECL, the propagation delay of ECL is 0.75, which is minimum. The propagation delay is minimum means its response would be fast and would be the fastest. So here the minimum propagation delay means it is the fastest of all logic families. So here this statement is correct. Another statement, the reason is given here. High speed in ECL is because the transistors are used in different amplifier configuration in which they are never driven into saturation and the storage time is eliminated. This is also correct statement. So here we'll choose option 1. Now next question we have. The synchronous speed of an induction motor can be varied by varying the frequency of the applied voltage. With a smaller frequency of operation, there is a large value of slip and motor rotates non-linearly with the frequency of the applied voltage. So here I will show you some statements. The synchronous speed of the rotor in RPM is given as n is equal to 120 f by p. Based on this formula, in previous exams they asked the question, where f is the frequency of the stator current and p is the number of poles. The operating speed n0 is given as n minus ns, where this ns is the slip speed. So from these two statements we can conclude the frequency of the rotor current fr is equal to ns into p upon 120, means the frequency of the rotor current is proportional to the slip speed. If frequency is smaller, then slip speed should be also small, but here it is written that large value of slip. So this statement will say wrong. And the synchronous speed of an induction motor can be varied by varying the frequency of the applied voltage. This statement is correct. So here assertion is true but reason is false. So we will choose option 3. One more thing, if the operating speed is 0, ns would be equal to n, and the frequency of the rotor current is the same as the frequency of the stator current. Now question number 93. Assertion is given, the diameter of SMF, SMF means single mode fiber, is selected in such a way that single fundamental ray travels straight along the axis of the core of the fiber. So this is the correct statement. The diameter of a core of SMF is more than 10 micrometer and outer diameter is less than 125 micrometer. Here I like to show you the single mode fiber structure. So here at the first core is of 8 micrometer diameter. Here it is given that it should be more than 10 micrometer. So this is wrong. And the outer diameter is less than 125 micrometer, but this outer diameter, which is fourth one, written that should be 400 micrometer. So this is also wrong. So here reason is wrong but assertion is true. So here we'll choose option 3 again. Question number 94. Assertion is given, the stability analysis of systems with dead time can be conducted easily using the Bode plots. Here I would like to show you the dead time is shown here and the response is not started. So here stability analysis system dead time can be conducted easily using the Bode plot. This is the correct statement. The magnitude plot of a system is unaffected by the presence of a dead time. So here you can see the dead time. So here magnitude plot of a system is unaffected by the presence of dead time. This is also correct, and because of this we can do the stability analysis. So assertion and reason both are true and reason is the explanation of assertion. So we'll choose option 1 here. Next question we have, a non-return to zero NRZ type digital recording system is more common and efficient. This is correct. It is possible to record twice the number of digits for the same number of pulses. This is also correct statement, and the reason is the explanation of the assertion. So here we'll choose option 1. Now here we have passage for questions from question number 96 to 100. From the passage we understand that the questions are from the control system. So here we'll jump to the question. Which of the following statements is correct? So here feedback can only increase the sensitivity of a system. Here we need to understand about the sensitivity of a system. This is given as S. A sensitivity of a transfer function given the gain. This is given as G upon T del T upon del G. Consider there is a system has gain G. This is output C of S and input R of S. And there is a feedback H. So here this is minus and this is plus. So we know the transfer function would be equal to G upon 1 plus G into H. Here I am not writing of S, because we know that G and H are in terms of S. So here T is over G upon 1 plus GH. The differentiation of T with respect to G would be 1 plus GH whole square 1 plus GH into differentiation of G would be 1 minus G into differentiation of 1 plus gs would be 0 plus h. So from here del t upon del g would be this gh and this gh minus gh would be cancelled out. We will get 1 upon 1 plus gh whole square. So here on putting the values of this, g upon t is our g upon g 1 plus gh into 1 upon 1 plus gh whole square. So here square will be cancelled out, g would be cancelled out. This would be equal to 1 upon 1 plus gh. This is our denominator in which h is a feedback. So we talk about this statement here. If 1 plus gh is greater than 1, then sensitivity will decrease, and if 1 plus gh is less than 1, the sensitivity will increase. So the feedback can increase or decrease the sensitivity of the system. Second one would be the correct answer. Now next question we have: a good control system should be very sensitive to parameter variations. Insensitive to parameter variations, sensitive to input commands, sensitive to input commands. A good control system should be insensitive to parameter variations to avoid the unwanted responses of the system, and should be sensitive to the input commands in order to control the response of the system. So B and D are correct. You have to choose the correct statement. The third one is our option. Now question number 98. The open loop transfer function of a unity feedback control system is given by g of s is equal to 25 upon s into s plus 5. The steady state error will be, we know the steady state error E of s is given as limit s tends to 0 s into E of s, where this E of s is given as r of s upon 1 plus g of s h of s. So here g of s is given 25 upon s into s plus 5. H of s, there is a unity feedback, so this is 1 here, and r of s is the input, and we consider it a unit step input. So in, so on putting the values, we'll get limit s tends to 0 s into 1 over s square upon 1 plus gs is given 25 upon s into s plus 5. So here on solving this, we will get limit s tends to 0, here this would be cancelled out, and this s would be cancelled out with this s, and we'll get, now by applying the limit this s tends to 0, this would become 5 upon 25, and 5 upon 25 is equal to 0.2 radian. So this is our correct option in option number 2, 0.2 radian. Here is question number 99. The sensitivity of the overall closed loop transfer function for the system shown below with respect to forward path transfer function at omega is equal to 1 radian per second will be. So in previous question we have find the expression for the sensitivity, and it is given as st g is given as 1 over 1 plus g into h, where this g is given as 25 upon s into s plus 2, and h is given 0.25 into 0.25. here on further solving this, so would be s square plus 2s upon s square plus 2s plus 6.25. we know that s is equal to g omega, and omega is equal to 1 is given, so s is equal to j. This would be s is equal to j. So on putting the value of s equal to j, j square would be minus 1 plus 2j upon minus 1 plus 2j plus 6.25. so here this would be equal to minus 1 plus 2j upon 6.25 6.25 minus 1 would be 5.25 plus 2j. Now the magnitude of this would be the sensitivity. So here this would be 1 plus 4 upon square root of 5.25 whole square plus 4. On solving this we will get 0.398. So here this is in the fourth option, our fourth option is the correct one. Now next question. For an open loop control system, sensitivity of overall transfer function M of S with respect to forward path transfer function G of S will be. So as solving previous question, the sensitivity for this overall transfer function with respect to function, this would be G upon M del M upon del G. Here for open loop control system, this will look like this. It has only gain, there is no feedback, so its overall transfer function M of S would be equal to G of S only. So here and so del M upon del G would be 1 here. So on putting the values, and M is equal to G here, so G upon G into 1, so it would be 1. So here our correct answer would be 1. So that's all about for this video. Here we completed the paper 2 of electronic science asked in July 2018 exam. For rest of the questions, please find the playlist available on my YouTube channel. For previous year question papers and their solutions are also available in the playlist of my YouTube channel Praveen254AA. So here in the last, I would like to say thanks for your kind attention. Your all suggestions are most welcome. Please like, share and comment and subscribe my channel Praveen254AA. All the best friends. Thank you very much.